Hello, this is Melvin here yet again with another session. Okay, today I'm going to cover market structure. Okay, and I see this as the second part of market structure. So what I'll be sharing with you is a structure, an essay structure, okay, which can be used to address some questions that have proven or have appeared to be quite popular of late. So what kind of questions am I looking at? Now, students should know that market structure, okay, usually requires you to focus on explaining the features of a firm, right? Explaining how they behave in terms of price and competitive behavior, okay? And finally, evaluating their performance. So I covered all three concepts together with my methodologies in the previous video, okay? So today, what I'm going to run through with you is probably you can see as a subset of evaluation of the firm's performance. Okay, questions like this pertain to the impact of any event, okay, on the firm. So the event stipulated could be anything ranging from global recession, protectionism, globalization, okay, anything. And students are required to assess how this will affect different firms in different ways. So let's go through some examples when this has been tested. Okay, so I've collated the past year A-level questions here, alright, and you can see that in the year 2013, okay, 2013, students were asked to explain what happens when there's a recession, okay, whether smaller firms, alright, or more competitive markets are more vulnerable to closure. Okay, so this is clearly asking us to assess the impact of a recession on different firms, but 2013 was not the only time when it was tested, okay. If I look across to 2011, you see? So here, again, we have a question on the effects of a recession on different firms. Okay, if I go even way back, in 2005, okay, students had to assess how a fall in market demand, which could be due to a recession, all right, or a change in taste and preferences, would affect hotels, which are either oligopolistic or MC in nature. Okay? And there are even more examples if you look across to, say, the school's prelim papers, right? So, what I'm going to share with you is a CRASS framework, okay? It reads CRASS. The CRASS framework means, okay, students have to take that event and assess how it affects a firm's cost structure. So, when I look at costs, it could pertain to a change in your fixed or variable cost, okay? So if let's say the event pertains to a rise in rental cost, okay, that's going to affect your fixed cost, which means your AC changes, but not your MC curve. But if the event pertains to, say, the imposition of a minimum wage in Singapore, now wages count as variable cost, right? So when wages change, there'll be a change in AC and MC, okay? So you should first assess how the cost impact occurs, alright? Following the cost impact, you can also look at the revenue impact. So if this pertains to a recession, revenue is going to fall, right? If you assume that the firm sells normal goods. So it's also noteworthy that we should consider YED before you can determine whether revenue or demand indeed falls, okay? So after you look at revenue and cost, you can actually move to the fifth point. You don't have to go in order, okay? So if cost goes up, okay, you can consider whether the firm is likely to shut down in the short run. So if let's say variable cost increases to the extent ABC exceeds AR, now this firm is going to shut down in the short run. Okay, so that's the extension of your analysis. Okay, so let me just recap. First, look at the cost impact. And you can show this on the diagram, right? Could be a shift in MC or MC and AC curve. After you consider the cost impact, you look at what happens to revenue. So if revenue falls, you're going to show an inward shift of both AR and MR, okay? And finally, you combine your analysis to see whether the firm is likely to shut down. Now, if the firm shuts down, or rather if the shutdown condition is triggered, this is where you can bring in some firm-specific attributes, okay, to assess what eventually happens. So if the firm has reserves from previous accumulated profits, alright? I'm looking at oligopolies and monopolies, which can accumulate supernormal profits. So if there are reserves, this firm can use them to cushion any losses, which means this firm may not close down in the short run. Okay? But on the other hand, if you look at the smaller firms may be more nimble. They may be more flexible. So let's say during a recession, there's a fall in demand for accommodation, okay, from tourists. A budget hotel can convert into maybe a worker's dorm or a student hostel, and they may still tap on a stable pool of demand. But this is something that a bigger firm cannot do. Okay, so there are some compensating differences between the different types of market structure. Right? So if you refer to my book, I gave an example of a global recession, and I considered what happens to revenue, what happens to your cost, cost, okay, and whether the firm has supernormal profits to act as a buffer. And this is, of course, in relation to the shutdown condition. Alright? Same thing for adaptive ability of the firm. Alright, so this is just one work example, but so far I find the CRASS framework, okay, pretty useful for questions of this type. Okay? So this is a short video because it's just a specific structure which I feel has become more relevant with the style of the questions lately. Okay? So that's all. Thank you.